how you can save money as a student studying in Germany. Interestingly, I didn't know about this while I was studying. If I knew about it, I would have saved a lot of money for myself. People when they think about studying abroad, amongst every other question that they ask, one of the things that they ask is, how do I get a student job? Is it possible for me to get a job in the city where I want to study? What are the chances to get a student job? How much do they pay per hour? In my other videos, which you would find in my profile, I talked about how to find a job or how to find student jobs. So today, I'd like to give mainly three tips that I feel like would really help you on how to save money as a student in Germany. The very first one is saving on tax as a student. That might sound really crazy. Ask yourself, how can you save on tax? And for those of you who know, as a student, when you work in Germany, you have a certain number of days that you can work in a year and also a certain amount of hours that you are allowed to work per week. And also that translates to a certain amount that you earn per month. If you earn the minimum amount that you're supposed to as a student, you don't get taxed on that. But if you earn more than that, you get taxed on whatever amount you earn. But that's not the focus. So the focus is now, let's imagine you're not even working. How can you save money from the little that you have? As a student, you buy phones, you buy a laptop, you buy a textbook, you buy shoes, you buy clothes, table, chairs, you buy stuff that may be directly or indirectly related to your studies. If you say they're directly related to your study, I mean, if you have a laptop, for instance, it's obvious you would want to use it to study. All those items that you buy, you're charged 19% on tax. That's the case in Germany, as far as I know. As a student, you can get a tax return from all these items. How do you go about this? Normally, if you're a worker, I think once or twice per year, you can always apply for tax return. For those people who know how to do it, you can stay at home with certain programs that are compatible with the Ministry of Finance or the Finance Office of your state or city. But not to stress yourself too much, there are different agencies that can do this for you. I recommend, for the first time, use all these guys. They call them Steuerberater in German. Or if you translate it to English, it would mean tax consultant. If you've bought so many things over the course of the year, and it really does not matter how, when you bought those things, what matters is that you keep all the receipts, because you need to tender the receipt for you to get the tax return. So if you're already studying here, I guess this information is still valuable to you. Interestingly, I didn't know about this while I was studying. If I knew about it, I would have saved a lot of money for myself. That's one. The second one is you get subsidies on certain kind of subscription. Now think about different kind of programs that you might need to use as a student. It could be anything. It could be subscription on Microsoft programs. Most universities will give you that. So it's important to know that certain computer programs, you do not need to buy them as a student. It's really, really important. If you buy as a student, in my opinion, you're just wasting your money, because you get it from the school anyway for free in most cases. And let's imagine your school is not offering that. As a student, with your student identity card and your student, I don't know, enrollment certificate or whatever, you can always get some of these offers or some of these packages at a really, really subsidized rate. The point here is this: if you want to make any kind of subscription, always look out for the option of subsidy for students. The third one that I'd like to talk about is saving on transportation. As a student, automatically, your identity card is already your ticket for transportation, at least within that city. In some other cases, it could even be as far as the whole state. And there are certain states that even have cooperation with each other. For example, Berlin and Brandenburg. Most students in Berlin, they can use their student ticket to travel all around the state of Berlin and also in Brandenburg. And that being said, also for certain long distance travel, it could also be maybe like traveling with a train from maybe one part of Europe to another. Always watch out for packages for students. There are always packages for students. And why is this important? You're thinking about studying abroad, you're asking questions about if you're going to have a job or not. But then the point is this: even the little money that you have, you could actually save from that if you understand some of these little tricks. That's mainly what I have for you today. Hopefully in the next time I could go into even more. Thank you very much for today, and I will see you at about same time next week.